Be aware, there are spoilers. As the movie begins, we see some people are getting on a private plane from New York and are greeted by the captain. The plane takes off and there is a montage of the high life, which the passengers obviously lead. The plane lands and the passengers are taken away in a fleet of luxury cars. Two of the passengers, Amber and Tony, are at the front of the group. They arrive at the harbor and Amber is really annoyed to see the ship that they will be getting onto. Tony tries to convince her that everything will be okay. They are all greeted by the captain of the ship, but Amber is really snotty towards him. One of the crew members named Pepe is angry about her attitude and the way that the captain behaves with her, but he is instructed to show her to her cabin. She then asks about the gym, and Pepe says that he would bring the gym to her. It is just an exercise bike, and she screams at her husband. Pepe then brings a jump rope, with which she threatens to strangle the captain. At dinner, another passenger named Debbie enthuses about this trip from Greece to Italy. The other guests mock her before Tony arrives casually dressed. Amber is annoyed because they had all agreed to dress up for dinner. In the kitchen, Pepe tells the captain that he can deal with Amber, but the captain says that he is being well paid to do this job. The guests are swimming, except for Amber. Pepe is trying to be nice to her, but she is being awful. Later, Amber is on the bike debating capitalism versus communism, then money and fame. Pepe listens and tells the captain that she is rude and heartless. Suddenly, she snaps her fingers at him, demanding water and a towel. He obliges begrudgingly. Later, when the female guests are sunbathing, Pepe stops two crew members from spying on them, but then watches for a while himself. Amber notices. She continues to treat him horrifically throughout the day. The guests gamble that evening while Pepe fishes. They say that he was a full-time fisherman until pollution put an end to it. They ask him his opinion, and he says that chemicals have made life easier for some, but easier doesn't mean better. Money corrupts people's principles. At breakfast, Amber complains about the food, and finally, Pepe snaps and throws the bowl over her head. She screams at Tony to do something, but Pepe warns him not to, and then throws Amber over the side and into the sea. But it was all in his imagination, and instead, he takes it back to the kitchen. The kitchen team tastes the food and determines that it is all okay. The captain tells them to cook it again anyway. He goes to apologize to Amber, and she asks if they are being punished for being rich. He says of course not, and he loves their money. The guests spend the day on shore, and when they return, Amber overhears Pepe swear to the captain. She complains, but the captain manages to smooth it over. She insists that they cook her the fish that she bought that day for dinner. The chef refuses to cook the poor quality fish she provided, so instead they cook Pepe's fish and serve it up to her instead. She has no idea. That night, the boat is rocking, and as Pepe carries a fish through the corridor, he bumps into Amber. She starts to flirt with him a little, as she is quite drunk, and tries to stop him from passing. She asks for a dance, but he says that he won't dance with people he doesn't like. The following night, the wives stay up playing cards and drinking. Amber goes up on deck, and Pepe watches from a distance. She notices him watching and walks away. The next day, the other guests visit some caves, leaving Amber behind. She insists that she wants to go as well, and Pepe is instructed to take her. Although he thinks it is a bad idea, due to the distance and the current, he obliges. As they travel towards the cave, the engine breaks down. Pepe tries to restart it, but to no avail. Amber worries that they are drifting too far, and he tells her that he warned her about the current. Night falls, and they are still adrift. Amber is furious. The next morning, Pepe bemoans his poor life. He tries to fix the engine again, but drops a tool overboard. He dives down to try to retrieve it, just as Amber wakes. She thinks he has left her or drowned, and starts to scream his name. He comes up and asks if she missed him. She demands to know why her friends haven't come to find her yet, and Pepe informs her that the sea is a big place. He clambers aboard, and she starts to search the boat. She finds a flare gun. Later, Pepe catches a fish and gives it to Amber to eat raw. She thinks that it's disgusting and throws it away. Pepe is angry as it took him hours to catch it. Suddenly, in the distance, they see a ship. Amber tries to fire the flare gun, but when it doesn't work, Pepe tries to take it off of her. They struggle, and the gun goes off, puncturing the inflatable boat. Amber screams out loud in anger. They cling to the deflated raft as night falls and a storm takes hold. They wake the next morning, and Amber spies land. They paddle towards it and stumble to shore. Pepe climbs higher, but finds that they are on a small deserted island. Amber will not accept that this place can be deserted and calls him a hairy, useless midget. He tells her to watch her mouth and storms away shouting at her. Pepe finds a shed and makes a little camp, fashioning tools and collecting fresh water. Amber explores alone and finally finds Pepe. She sees him drinking and eyes up the bottle thirstily. As he leaves to go spearfishing, she sneaks up and steals his water. He sees her as he returns and she smiles smugly. However, he has caught a lobster and eats as she looks on enviously. She tells him that she will pay him for his fish, but he says that he is not interested in her money. She angrily throws sand at him and he slaps her in the face, telling her that he is in charge now. He tells her to do his laundry and then he will feed her. And from now on, she should call him master. He gives her his clothes to wash. She returns and he insists that she thanks him for the privilege. He asks her to fill his bottle with water, and then he gives her some of the lobster. He retires to his shed, but won't let her in. She complains that she is cold and won't survive another night, but he won't let her in. The next morning, he wakes her early and tells her to clean his room. Later, they fish together and she cooks it for him. She tells him that if he is decent to her, then she will reward him. He asks how she knows that anyone will rescue them. He tells her that she will be punished every time that she disobeys him, just like she did to him on the ship. Later, they fish together again, and he catches an octopus, but she is scared and throws it away. Afterwards, she goes to sit down, but Pepe insists that she wait on him. He reminds her that he is her master now, and asks her to sing and dance for him. As he looks on, he is amazed by her performance. The next day, he smokes as she does her chores. They start the fight and he chases after her. They struggle on the sand dunes and he holds her down. She finally succumbs to his demands, but then he leaves her, telling her that he must fall in love first. He tells her that he will become her god and that she doesn't know yet who he is. Sometime later, Amber is sitting on a rock in contemplation. The next morning, she brings home some firewood and then they have a happy time together on the beach. Eventually, she is allowed to sleep in the shed. As time passes, they seem to enjoy each other's company more, and she becomes more adept at survival. One morning, while collecting firewood, she spots a yacht, but decides not to call out for it. She is quiet that night and asks him if he would prefer to be with someone younger. He says that he is a man, and he wants to be with a woman, not a girl. It starts to rain, and inside, Pepe discovers a bottle of alcohol and starts to drink. Amber takes some as well, and they begin to loosen up. Next day, while fixing fishing nets, she tells Pepe that she loves him. He believes that if they hadn't been shipwrecked, then they would still be the same. Later, she catches an octopus alone and presents him with some eggs. He tells her that he's done to her what needed to be done. She playfully throws the eggs at him, and he chases her. They spend more happy times together, and her skills and attitude improve. Sometime later, they awake on the beach together and see a yacht off the coast. She pleads with him not to call out, but he says that if she loves him, then she must prove it in the real world. She continues to beg, but he insists. The two are finally saved. Their rescuers tell Amber that she has been on the news. The captain tells her that her husband is coming to meet her. He goes on to tell Pepe that they have been away for over a month and the whole world has been talking about them. Her husband is rich, and Pepe will be rewarded well. At the harbor, Tony thanks Pepe for his services. Tony is embracing Amber, and Pepe walks away and goes to a bar. A man follows him in to offer him a big reward. Pepe throws the man out, but he leaves without the bag, which contains a lot of money. Pepe goes to the jeweler's and purchases a ring with the cash. Amber arrives at the hotel with Tony and receives a phone call from Pepe. She asks why he took so long to call. He tells her that he has been calling, but no one told her. He tells her that he does love her and that they have to find a way. She tells him to leave a message at reception, telling her what to do, and she will do it. He writes a letter telling her that he will have a boat waiting for their runaway in the morning and delivers it to the night receptionist, telling her to give it to Amber only. Amber wakes in the morning and checks for messages. Suddenly, Tony joins her and the receptionist gives them a letter, but this is about the helicopter. They get into the helicopter later as Pepe waits at the harbor. Tony passes Amber an envelope with a $100 bill, telling her to tip the bellboy. The envelope is actually the letter from Pepe, which has the location of his boat written on it. The bellboy takes the letter to Pepe, who rips it open. It contains the ring. The bellboy directs Pepe to the helicopter, and Pepe runs towards it. Amber cries as the helicopter leaves, just before Pepe arrives. He throws the ring into the ocean, devastated. Like and subscribe to watch more videos like this. And don't forget to turn on your notifications. That really helps my channel. Thanks for watching.